as an audition for a Black Caps Test cricket spot in a calamitous situation. It was an impressive one by Henry Nicholls at Wellington's Basin Reserve on Monday. But the young left-hander's 82 off 111 balls was put in the shade by what happened next in a remarkable late-on slot in the first one-day international against Pakistan. It got a bit crazy in the Wellington sun as tail-enders Matt Henry and Mitchell McLennigan lifted the Black Caps from struggling to make par to a formidable total of 280-8. The full house at the Basin finally found their voice as the pair slammed 73 off 5.3 overs to post a New Zealand record ninth wicket stand against Pakistan and ensure the tourists have to work hard for victory on a bouncy pitch with something in it for the quicker men. Henry was 48 not out off 30 balls, slamming 4 sixes including one that sailed out of the ground. McLennigan, even less known for his batting, backed him up with 31 off 18 balls including a nifty lap shot. There was a moment of drama when McLennigan was felled by a bouncer from Anwar Ali off the penultimate ball of the innings. It looked nasty as McLennigan hit the deck, but he rose to his feet and wandered off to rousing ovation, retired hurt with a towel clutched to his ear. He soon received stitches near left eye, but didn't initially appear for New Zealand's bowling effort as he was being treated at a nearby hospital, with Adam Milne substituting him on the field. Anwar's figures blew out to 3-66 and he had to complete an over for Mohammad Adamir, 3-28, who limped off the field with what appeared a left shin injury after the first ball of his ninth over. When Nicholls departed at 203-8 in the 45th over, the Black Caps would have gladly taken 250, with wickets tumbling around him. Nicholls defied an accurate, lively Pakistan pace attack on the bouncy surface. Nicholls wasn't even in this 13-man squad before Ross Taylor was ruled out for the Pakistan and Australia Otis with a side strain, summoned from Canterbury. Having debuted against Sri Lanka on Boxing Day, Nicholls took on an early short pitch barrage and survived a dropped catch on 15 to show some patience and bail New Zealand out of deep trouble. With Taylor a doubtful starter for the first test against Australia at the same venue on February 12, and Brendan McCullum set to retire from test cricket after that series, a batting spot is up for grabs and Nicholls, already the front-runner, is now a short-priced favorite to step in. Pakistan's left-arm new ball duo found a pitch to their liking, as the ground hosted its first ODI in 11 years. Giant Mohammad Irfan and Amir both extracted bounce and openers Martin Guptill and Tom Latham perished when taking on the short ball. Then the relatively conventional right-armer Anwar caused more damage. He had Nicholls dropped at slip, a regulation chance to Mohammad Hafiz, then struck twice in 3 balls. Captain Kane Williamson inside-edged one that nipped back, then Grant Elliott got too ambitious second ball with a big drive and the ball seamed through a yawning gate. New Zealand's batsmen, coming off 5 2020 internationals, seemed in a hurry and we're surprised by the steep bounce. Corey Anderson pushed too hard at one from Amir and edged. Then Luke Ronchi's poor summer against the white ball continued when he wafted at one after facing just 7 balls. BJ Watling comes in for Napier in Auckland as Ronchi rests, and the Wellington gloveman now finds his spot under increasing pressure. Nicholls, meanwhile, was strong to the short ball square of the wicket, found the gaps and drove strongly when it was pitched up. His highest score from 4 previous innings was an unbeaten 23 and he toughed it out and reached his maiden half-century off 71 balls. All-rounder Mitchell Santner also survived a dropped chance in the deep on 11 that could have cooked New Zealand's goose. From 99-6, he and Nicholls added a vital 79 for the 7th wicket. Santner passed his highest ODI score of 44 and took on the spinners as Pakistan let the heat off before Irfan got one to bounce and Santner skied a catch on 48. New Zealand, Martin Guptill, Tom Latham, Kane Williamson, Captain Henry Nicholls, Grant Elliott, Corey Anderson, Luke Ronchi, Mitchell Santner, Matt Henry, Trent Bolt, Mitchell McLennigan, Pakistan, Azhar Ali, Captain, Ahmed Shahzad, Muhammad Hafiz, Babar Azam, Sohaib Maqsood, Imad Wasim, Sarfraz Ahmed, Anwar Ali, Wahab Riaz, Muhammad Amir, Muhammad Irfan.